I'm Dr. Janine Barry, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about diet and EMF exposure. So what can we do in our diet to decrease our risk of that EMF or EMR, so electromagnetic fields or electromagnetic radiation damage to our bodies and to our cells? Well, one of the first things we can do is to increase niacin-containing foods in our diet. So niacin is very important, vitamin B3, and this is a precursor to NAD. So NAD is something that increases with exercise, but it is depleted by EMFs, and that's the danger here. And a lot of research has gone into NAD and its relationship with having a long health span and living long, and for anti-aging research, there's a lot being done right now on NAD and has been for the last 10 years or so. And you may have heard about NAD and NAD supplementation, and that's definitely possible, but whenever we can get these precursors to NAD, like niacin, from our diet, that's definitely a good way to go, because getting it the whole food sources of these vitamins is definitely very important. So some of the foods that contain niacin and are great amounts of niacin include, so both vegetarian and non-vegetarian, let's start with the non-vegetarian first, would be tuna. So tuna has great amounts of niacin, as does chicken breast. So if you are a meat eater, these would be, you know, some of the sources that you're getting these NAD precursors, as well as pork. So pork, again, for the meat eaters, is a great source of niacin. Salmon as well. So salmon also contains DHA, which is important, which I'll talk about as well. But getting that DHA sometimes from a supplement is a better way to go because of the toxicity. So just be very mindful when you are having these meat sources for your niacin that you're getting it from a good source so that you're lowering your toxic load. As well as turkey. So turkey, for those of you, we have Canadian Thanksgiving is coming up soon. A great time to enjoy turkey. And if you can get free range organic, definitely better. Steak is another source of niacin, and as well as anchovies. So anchovies, being a smaller fish, is sometimes better because of less toxicity because of the size of the fish. So that would be a great option as well for your niacin. Now let's look at some vegetarian sources of niacin. So this would include nutritional yeast. So I know a lot of vegetarians, vegans, they love using nutritional yeast in recipes, as well as peanuts. So peanuts, again, preferably organic, because we don't want to have that exposure to the pesticides, which are very common with peanut exposure. So go organic with the peanuts or peanut butter. Avocados also have a natural great source of niacin, and mushrooms. So maitake and portobello mushrooms have niacin as well. Again, your precursor to that NAD, great for anti-aging, but great to prevent that EMF exposure damage to your cells. Now, another thing that we can do in terms of the diet is called fasting. So whether it's intermittent fasting or a prolonged fast, what these can do is they can help to make sure that you're decreasing that risk of the EMF damage by going into autophagy. So autophagy is your body's natural cleanup mechanism. And the way that you do this is to do the fast. So you're taking periods of time in which you're not eating so that your body can go into that cleanup mechanism. So with intermittent fasting, this is usually the easiest segue into fasting for if you're going to try for prolonged periods of time. And the intermittent fasting means that you're choosing an eating window. So most people start with about an 8-hour window of eating. So for example, if you start eating at 12 noon, you would be able to eat from 12 till 8 p.m., that's your 8-hour window, and then after 8 p.m. until 12 the next day at noon, you are not eating, and that's your fasting window. Some people shorten their eating window even more. Some, you know, are at 4 hours, but if you can do then, once you get used to the intermittent fasting, then you can prolong it and you can try to do a 24-hour fast. So that's something I'd love, if you are big on fasting, I'd love to hear from you below in the comments. I would love to, you know, get your take on fasting and how that's helped you, because I know it's helped thousands and thousands of people, not only for, you know, getting into autophagy, but for weight loss also. And more importantly, in today's topic, to help to protect against that EMF damage. Now, another thing that I'd like to discuss is something called the NRF2 pathway. And this is a pathway that is more recently discovered. And what this pathway does, it's like a master switch to turn on your antioxidant status in your own body. And this is something that is great because it increases the production of your antioxidants, helps to decrease inflammation in the body, and increases detox pathways. So that's important in the liver, but also in your other organs to increase that detoxification. So now you're lessening your impact of those EMFs and that radiation on your cellular mechanisms. So that's really important. So there are specific foods and nutrients that help to turn on this NRF2 pathway. So let's start with green tea. So green tea is something that I love, whether it's supplemented or you're drinking 2 to 3 cups of green tea every day. Make sure that's a high quality, preferably organic green tea, but green tea contains something called EGCG. This is a potent antioxidant, which has a lot to do with protection of our cells. So that's something that also, of course, increases the NRF2 pathway. So increasing your own internal antioxidant status and the production of your own antioxidants internally. Now, another great food or drink is grapes or red wine. So yes, a little bit of red wine in moderation, of course, contains resveratrol, which also activates the NRF2 pathway, which is fantastic. And we know the, you know, vast amount of benefits from having red wine and that resveratrol. Now, certainly if you're watching your carbohydrates, and this is something else that I discussed in a previous episode, is we don't want to be spiking our blood glucose when we're trying to protect our body from that EMF radiation. Now, some people can get away with it. If you live very close to the equator, you can get a little bit more carbohydrate into your diet. But for the most part, we really have to watch our carb exposure. And why is that? Because the damaging rays of those EMFs and that radiation has more of an impact in our bodies when our insulin levels are not balanced. And this is something a lot of research is going into this right now. And that's why it's been shown that, you know, by balancing our carbohydrates and having more of the healthy fats in our diet, this is very protective for that EMF radiation. So if you're going to go with the resveratrol, sometimes supplementation is a better way to go without the carbs and without the sugar. But also to have a little bit of red wine and some red grapes here and there is okay. Just don't do it in the mornings. That's when you're more insulin sensitive. And garlic. So I love garlic. Garlic is nature's antibiotic, has so many different beneficial effects, helps to thin the blood and keep the viscosity of the blood healthy, but also activates our NRF2 pathway. So that's important, again, for our internal antioxidant status. And again, we want to do everything as naturally as we can. And of course, protecting ourselves from EMFs is something that we absolutely have to think about every day. So whether it is from our cell phones, whether it's from Wi-Fi, whether it is from the 5G towers and we're in close proximity, it could even be baby monitors, we have to make sure that we are decreasing our exposure as much as possible. So thanks for joining me today. Give me a big thumbs up and thanks for watching. Leave your questions and comments below. And remember to always take care of your good health and do it naturally.